My name is Erin Diamond, and I'm a graduate student in speech-language pathology. I graduated from CLA with undergraduate majors in speech-language-hearing sciences and Spanish studies. I discovered the field originally in high school, and then I kind of looked at my classes through the lens of what if I was going to study the speech and language part of this. So in psychology, I thought about the language parts of the brain, and it kept being interesting. So when I got to the university, I took introductory coursework in the department, and I haven't looked back. The undergraduate degree in speech-language-hearing sciences most directly prepares you for professions in speech-language pathology or audiology, and both of those require graduate degrees. So the speech pathology track requires a master's degree, and audiology requires a professional doctorate. There are a lot of people who go into speech-language-hearing sciences as an undergraduate and then take a different route towards something like special education or counseling, but to work directly in the speech or the hearing field, graduate school is the next logical step. As a graduate student, we have coursework and we also have clinical experiences called practicum. That dynamic is an important one. We learn from clinicians who are already in the field, and then we get to bring that back to our classes and talk to our peers and apply the theory to what we've been experiencing out in the real world. Initially, what excited me about the discipline of speech-language-hearing sciences was the variety of influences that the field has. You focus on biology, you learn about psychology, you work with people. It can be medical, but you can work in a school setting. And it was really that variety that appealed to me because I didn't have a clear direction of exactly what job I wanted, but this was a field that had so many interesting pieces and could lead me to a wide variety of jobs. It's really important to open doors wherever you can, whether that be through taking courses that are related or getting involved in extracurricular activities, volunteering. To be successful as an undergraduate in speech-language-hearing sciences, I think it really just takes curiosity and hard work. So a lot of this material is very new. You don't learn about the anatomy of the ear in high school. So it takes an open mind and kind of embracing the fact that you don't have the foundational knowledge in all of these things, but it's worth studying and it's interesting to study. And if you work through kind of the complicated pieces, what you get to do in the future is really incredible.